Hi, and thanks for watching the video. This is Todd Baginski. I'm a Microsoft MVP and the partner and CTO at Canvas. In this video, I'm going to give you a deep dive in PowerApps, and I'm going to show you inside of the Estimator Pro PowerApps sample template how you can create dynamic email templates inside of a PowerApp. The Estimator Pro PowerApps sample template allows you to create estimates for different projects you may have and then email those estimates to potential or current customers. If you wish to learn more about this PowerApp, I suggest you look at the deep dive video that I have for this PowerApp, as well as the installation instructions and the video which gives you an end-to-end walkthrough of the functionality. So in the interest of time in this video, since I'm just showing you how to create a dynamic email template in a PowerApp, I've already populated this PowerApp with information as well as attachment of a picture, a sketch, a couple different products, and a lot of information. And so now what I'd like to do is I'd actually like to send this estimate to someone. And when I click send here, it's going to send the email with all the information we saw on the previous page to this recipient. I can add more than one here if I like, with this email subject and this message. So I'm going to click send now and actually send that email off. And now that it's done in the app, I can create another estimate if I'd like. Now that the email's been sent, I can open it up and here's what it looks like. You can see the information we had in there before, as well as the attachment of the picture I took and also the sketch that was drawn in the app. So I'm going to dig into the app now and show you exactly how we are able to templatize this information and create dynamic email templates inside of the PowerApp. So now I've returned to the page where I actually sent the email. And as I mentioned in many of the videos that I've done for these different PowerApps we created, my favorite way to really learn how PowerApp's working and dig into it is to play it inside of the editor like I'm doing here in preview mode, and then take it out of preview mode, which allows me to inspect the controls, and I can dig right into the control here by clicking on the send button to really see what's happening here under the hood. So if you're ever working with the PowerApp and you want to figure out how it works, I suggest you follow the same process here. So there's more than one way you can actually go about creating templated pieces when you'd like to do exports to various places like email or OneNote in a PowerApp. The pattern that I'm showing here is one way to do it. Another pattern you can use, you can actually find in the Meeting Capture app. If you watch my deep dive video on how to export to OneNote there, we're also creating HTML and sending things in email there, and we use a different pattern that for creating dynamic templated based exports in PowerApps. So you could check out that pattern as well. But this pattern is a little bit more simple. This pattern essentially is going to generate some HTML in a context variable we call email HTML right here. And the way that this works is at the top of the page, we create a bunch of different collections that tells us which products, their names, the prices, all kinds of information and metadata about the current quote that's being built in the app. And it gives us all that information right here so that we can use it inside of our template. So our email HTML is essentially a string that you can see here is HTML. And we've even baked in the CSS here so we can style it and make sure it's always available for us. And you'll notice here we've just got the HTML that's going to create the email. So whenever we want to put something dynamic into that email, for example, the subject, that's where we grab that variable. And then we can also even look at the first item in the order detail collection, order date, and convert that to text, for example. And then here's our format that we're going to format that within. So the text function is being applied with this format to the order date coming out of this first item in this collection, which then puts the order date inside of the email as well. So whatever, as you can see, PowerApp functions you'd like to use with your data, you have full control over it here. It's a lot like doing things inside of a Razor page in ASP.NET or something like that. You can see several different places in here where our data is dynamic. And then one interesting spot is right here in the products section. So as we look at the email that we have, it looks like this. And so here is product one and product two. You can see we have a count of two of them in the product section here. And this is essentially using concatenation functions and different values out of the data that we have in PowerApps to test where we're at in that collection and render the HTML appropriately so we can actually stack things one after another. When we're all done creating our HTML, that ends right here at this line. And so here is the actual code that actually sends the email. So if someone has selected the checkbox that says send the current person a copy, then we would fall down into this category. If they said don't send the current person a copy, then we're in this category. The only difference is we add the CC with the current user's mail when we send the carbon copy there and copy the current user on it. The important things to point out about actually sending the email here, though, is if we look at the third argument, here is the body and the send email call to the Office 365 Outlook connector. Notice this is the email HTML context variable that we built up in the code just above this. And then the other key piece of the puzzle is HTML. We have that set to true because we are using HTML to format the email and make it look really nice here. If you're not using HTML in your email, you can still templatize things just in plain text and then just set this to false. So as you can see, it's very easy to go about creating an email template. And as I mentioned, there's other places and patterns where you can actually store this template and inject data into it. So I encourage you to check out the meeting capture video where it demonstrates how to store those templates in other places outside of the PowerApp so you don't actually have to update the template inside of the PowerApp here if you'd like to change it. Hope this technique comes in handy for you and you enjoy the PowerApp. Thanks for watching the video, and I'll see you next time.